थैंक यू।
व्हाट्स योर नेम?
वसंता
सर, वसंत कुमार सर।
योर फॉर्मेट लुक्स अ बिट डिफरेंट।
प्रोनाउंस इट वसंत और वसंता
सर। वसंत कुमार सर, जस्ट वसंत।
हां योर नेम।
सो यू आर इन आंध्र प्रदेश?
यस सर।
सेपरेट फ्रॉम तेलंगाना?
यस सर।
आई एम टोल्ड इन यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स दे हैव तेलुगु एसोसिएशंस।
Yes, sir.
And after this Andhra and Telugu, this Telangana were divided, they also separated and started enemy-like behavior. They would not see eye to eye with each other. Same thing happening in Andhra and Telangana. Is it true?
No, sir. As of now, I haven't heard of any such instances, sir. There are very cordial relations between people of both the states. They are like our brothers and sisters, just like earlier times. I'm not aware of the happenings in USA, sir.
It was there. See, I was handling one department in central government. Officers used to come together. When they were separated, they started blaming each other. No, this is not happening here. It was like this here. It was happening. And it is true for associations, I'm telling, in US. Telugu associations, they split into two. And they became enemy of each other. Okay, your father is in?
So my father works in a DISCOM, sir, in Andhra Pradesh. AP, EP, DCL, sir.
How is functioning?
Sir, it is functioning good, sir.
Power losses? What is the percentage of power losses?
So currently they have come down to 6%, sir. With respect to losses, it is functioning very well, sir. It has reduced losses from around 14% to 6% after bifurcation.
Which is the best DISCOM distribution state? Where it is losses are minimum.
Sir, AP EP DCL has the minimum losses, sir, but the overall functioning.
I'm talking about the country.
Sir, in country, sorry, sir.
And which is the worst?
Sir, recently, sir, the ratings have been given by the Power Finance Corporation. DISCOMs in Haryana and Delhi have got the good ratings, sir. It don't exist. Sir, I'm not aware.
If it's worse, Delhi is the best. Okay.
Thank you.
Tell me, what are the main 4-5 reasons for this power losses? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Sir, power losses are measured in terms of AT&C losses. Sir, it has both technical losses and commercial losses, sir. In technical losses, sir, there are power thefts. There are inefficiencies in billing. The transmission losses because of the material that we use. In commercial loss, sir, we have inefficiency in collection. These are major parameters in calculating the losses, sir.
Okay. Road safety. We have a lot of issues on road safety.
Yes, sir.
Now, yesterday, this road transport minister has given a statement in the parliament that number of cases have come down and number of deaths have come down. As compared to last year, but still cases are very high, accidents are taking place. Can you suggest 4-5 road safety measures where you can reduce the number of accidents and number of deaths?
So first, sir, the driving tests have to be strict and mandatory for the people. They have to be age limit. And also, sir, the recent motor vehicle amendment has been promising in reducing the number of vehicle accidents by strict implementation of it.
Tell me, what are these?
Secondly, sir, we have made mandatory the helmet for both pillion riders and the riders of bikes. It has reduced the number of accidents, sir. We can reduce them in future by reducing the number of potholes on the roads by going for good materials which are not corrosive to the rains or any other damages. Secondly, sir, there is a need for CCTV installations in various places which can directly send the challans or to the people to their mobiles. Thirdly, sir, we can go for zero tolerance against the driving with alcohol consumption. There is a need for
what can be water conservation structures in a agricultural land in a village. You know, water is a big problem.
Yes, sir.
Even Telangana also, in Andhra, yes, also, anywhere. how we can conserve water?
Sir, we have traditional water bodies, sir, in different areas with different names, with different structures, sir. We can rebuild them. We can increase the depth of them to retain rainwater.
Okay, okay, that is one.
Yes,
I'm asking, just give me 3-4 structures.
Sir, we can go for the bore wells. They are also good in water conservation, sir. They can be revamped again to their old structures. By increasing the depth, they can also store water, sir, especially the rainwater. And we can create sumps at various places, sir, which can store water, especially the rainwater. Thirdly, sir, that canal irrigation is also good in both conserving water and also...
I'm not asking about irrigation. I'm asking you conservation structures. Okay, right to work is a fundamental right?
Sir, right to work? Yes, sir.
How? You say, I want this job. This is my right. Can it be given?
No, sir. There should not be any discrimination towards any person in giving work, sir. And it comes under a personal... a person should not be discriminated if he wants to go for a work. So, sir, that is what our constitution has guaranteed.
You heard about Jio?
Yes, sir.
Jio company?
Yes, sir.
They are having so many things.
Yes, sir.
Can you name 3-4 of Jio Digital? What services they are providing?
Jio Mart is there, sir, which works in retail.
Okay.
Jio Telecom Operations, sir. So there is Jio TV and Jio Cinema. They are OTT platforms. Sir, and there are Jio Magazines and Jio News, which goes for which deals.
Okay, just tell me, what is this sketching and learning caricature? Sketching and learning caricature.
Sir, I do sketching from my childhood, sir. But in recently, from past 6-7 months, I'm trying to learn caricature, sir.
What is caricature?
Sir, caricature involves exaggeration of an event or a thing, sir, especially to create a sense of comic effect.
This caricature, human caricature also you will draw?
Yes, sir, I have some basic general caricatures for men and women and children, sir.
Can you draw my caricature?
Sir, I'll try to, sir. Yes, sir.
What is the status of capital formation in India?
Sir, as of now, the 3 capitals idea, sir, is under sub judice. It is not still approved. But as of now, sir, both people and government considers Amaravati as its capital, sir.
So how is it functioning?
Sir, the governance is functioning well, sir. But there are some protests from the farmers against the 3 capitals issue. They are stalling some governance process in the Amaravati region.
How has bifurcation of the state impacted the economy of your state in terms of revenue, in terms of employment?
Sir, post bifurcation, sir, Andhra Pradesh has lost Hyderabad, which used to be the major revenue producer to the government. But after that, sir, even then, Andhra Pradesh government is doing well, especially to bring investments to the state and also to boost employment, sir. It has created some skill councils to skill the youth, because the graduated youth is one of the advantage of Andhra Pradesh, sir. It is trying to skill them for the future. Secondly, sir, with respect to the revenue generation, sir, agriculture is doing well. And also, sir, the number of employed youth, the diaspora, the remittances, sir, they are all functioning very well, just like a prior bifurcation.
Is there any attempt to develop an alternative city like Hyderabad, IT hub?
Yes, sir.
Can you elaborate on this?
So, Andhra Pradesh government has been looking to develop Visakhapatnam as an IT hub, sir. There are two sets in Visakhapatnam, especially for the IT hub. They are created. And secondly, sir, even Amaravati is attracting some investments with respect to manufacturing, sir, not with IT. There is Kia company recently. It has established a manufacturing plant in Amaravati. So, sir, these are the major developments post bifurcation, sir.
You had a poster presentation on anti-corruption.
Yes, sir.
What is the status of Lokpal in the country?
Sir, as of now, sir, I'm not aware of the cases it is dealing with.
But is sir, it functional?
Yes, sir, it is functional, sir. After the there is some issue about the appointment of leader of opposition. It has been a non-starter for around 4-5 years, sir, because of lack of details regarding the procedure to file a complaint under Lokpal, appointment of leader of opposition in the committee, sir. But sir, recently, sir, the definition has been changed. The leader of single opposition party has been the member of Lokpal. And also, sir, the chairman of Lokpal has been appointed in 2019, sir, the Pinaki Chandra Ghosh ji. So, sir, but I'm not aware of the cases it is dealing with, sir.
We had this India Against Corruption movement, which was a massive movement in the country. Yes. Has the status of corruption in the country improved post the movement?
Sir, there is corruption still there, sir. It is there in multiple levels. If I say objectively with the rankings of Corruption Perception Index of Transparency International, sir, we have dropped in the rankings. So, sir, it shows that corruption is still there. It is increasing day by day. But at the same time, sir, we have taken multiple efforts to reduce the corruption. We have brought Lokpal. There are several other bodies, sir. We have Right to Information Act to improve the voluntary disclosure. So, sir, I do think that I'm optimistic that it will be reduced in future, but not completely, sir. The here and there corruption will be there at the lower levels.
Are we already using smart meters?
Sir, smart meters?
Yes.
Yes, sir.
There are some challenges with respect to smart meters. There are some issues in it.
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me about this?
So the major concern with smart meter is the cyber security issue, sir. They can be hacked because of the use of information communication technology. The energy consumption data can be changed, sir, which may prove negative to the DISCOMs, especially as they are facing with revenue collection, facing problems with revenue collection, sir.
Have you heard of the concept of sponge cities?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me?
Sir, sponge cities, they are type of smart cities, sir. They use different porous material which can take rainwater into the ground to recharge the aquifer, sir. So it is actually to prevent urban flooding.
Okay. Extreme climate events. This is constantly in news.
Yes.
Can you define what is an extreme climate event?
Sir, if an event it goes beyond the normal average circumstances, for example, sir, if I take the cyclone. Recently, sir, we are seeing very severe cyclonic storms compared to earlier normal tropical cyclones. The speed of the wind increased, the damage, the intensity of it increased hugely, sir. So, sir, these are some extreme climatic events. And also, sir, the after effects of the climatic events, like if we see the southern example of Western Ghats, after cyclones, sir, we are seeing landslides and post floods. So, sir, they are causing extreme damage to the infrastructure and also for the people's lives.
Do you think there is a lack of freedom of expression for cartoonists in the country?
Sir, I don't exactly think so, sir. There is freedom of expression, especially the artistic freedom. We are seeing so many cartoonists in our newspapers who are promoting their cartoons, even on the political issues, sir. So there is a lack of, sir, there is more liberalism in our country in accepting various other political views or social views, sir. But in the recent times, sir, we are seeing some sort of sedition cases against the cartoonists. For example, sir, the Manjul case, his Twitter account has been blocked because of cartoons, sir. So, sir, but cases here and there are happening.
Can you name three prominent Indian cartoonists?
Yes, sir. Sir, R.K. Lakshman, sir. He is known for his Common Man cartoon, sir. Sir, I know some contemporary cartoonist, sir, who draws in the newspapers. There is Sandeep Advaryu, sir, and E.P. Unni, sir.
Can you name the cartoonist of Economist?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware, sir.
Have you seen the cartoons of Economist?
No,
by
sir.
Any chance? Anyways. So you have read Anthropology?
Yes, sir.
Can you tell me, have humans been vegetarian or non-vegetarian?
Sir, there are both vegetarian and non-vegetarian in our humans, sir. Especially during our hunting-gathering age, we have started having a non-vegetarian also. We are getting huge catch at a small hunting. and we are consuming it for days. So, sir, there are both vegetarians and non-vegetarians, sir.
Raw meat or cooked meat? Did we have raw meat or cooked meat?
Sir, as a process of evolution, sir, before invention of fire, we are having the raw meat, and after invention of fire, sir, there is cooked meat, sir.
There is fire invented.
Sir. Sir, I could not exactly recall the dates, year, sir.
Which age?
Can you tell me the pre-Homo sapiens, some of these species of humans?
Sir, Neanderthals, Homo erectus, sir, and Australopithecus.
What is tape ball cricket?
Sir, tape ball is an tennis ball, sir, which is wrapped in an electrical tape, sir. It was practiced in Pakistan. It is good in producing good fast bowlers. But, sir, in the recent times, there have been tournaments in our country also conducted using tape ball, sir. And it is slowly percolating into the in our country, sir.
How do you actually play it? Like, what is the difference between the usual cricket?
Sir, it is just played like an usual cricket, but the ball differs, sir, because it increases bounce on the grassy pitches. So, sir, for getting good bounce on grass pitches at rural areas or also on grasslands, it is played, sir, and also there are some tournaments conducted at night time, sir. It can improve the visibility if we tape it with different colored tape. So, these are some reasons behind it, sir.
Do you think during the COVID times we should have cricket tournaments?
Yes, sir. That is an issue of dilemma, sir. On one side, the country is facing grief, and another side, people are looking for entertainment. But, sir, it was stopped at the right time. The moment the player safety and the people's safety is at risk, the BCCI has done good in stopping the tournament, sir. So, I think, sir.
What on-field restrictions have been brought for COVID protocols for cricket?
Sir, firstly, sir, there is restriction on using saliva in shining the ball, sir, because it can transmit the disease to the another person. And secondly, sir, the overall air bubble agreement has been in place, which prevented players from going outside and meeting other people outside.
And sir, can you tell me the import value of electronics last year or a couple of years back? Any data? How much of total we have imported electronics?
Sir, I'm not exactly aware of the numbers.
What is the government of India trying to curb, trying to reduce the import of electronics? What policies have been introduced?
Sir, recently there is production linked incentive scheme, sir, for the promotion of for the production of electronics at in our domestic industries, and also to boost our exports. Sir, there is National Electronic Policy 2019, which aims to generate around 10 million employment through the scheme, sir, and also to make us better in electronic sector, electronics manufacturing, sir. Thirdly, sir, the clusters have been created, electronics manufacturing clusters, just like they give policy incentives to them. And sir, it is especially to boost our domestic manufacturing of electronics, sir. So these are the major schemes that I could remember regarding electronics, sir.
Can you name some of the clusters, like which area it is there? Even if it is not a formal cluster, which area in India is leading in manufacturing of electronics?
Sir, Bangalore, sir. There are some companies like Foxconn. Sir, Chennai. Sir, in Delhi, sir, there is Samsung. Samsung has installed a plant here. And sir, apart from that, sir, I'm not aware of any other cluster.
You have done your graduation from Visakhapatnam?
Yes, sir.
Can you name some tourist places in Visakhapatnam?
Yes, sir. So there is Kailasgiri Hill, which has ropeway also, which gives a scenic beauty, sir. Secondly, sir, there is Kambalkonda Wildlife Sanctuary. The prominent animals are deer and leopards there, sir. And so the beaches, especially the Rushkonda Beach and RK Beach, are the famous beaches of Visakhapatnam, sir. And so there is Simhachalam Temple. There is a religious tourist spot, which annually attracts so many tourists. And apart from that, sir, even Visakhapatnam steel plant, it has also attracted some tourists, because there are some guides attached to it who show the whole Visakhapatnam steel plant working, sir.
Okay. Recently, there have been some IT income tax raids on media outlets. What is your opinion on that? Should government do? Is it amounting to curtailing the freedom of expression?
Yes, sir. Sir, I'm not exactly aware of the issue, sir. I just know the name of the media house and the issue behind it, whether the what is the news that they have projected in their website and why is it causing the issue, sir. I'm not exactly aware.
Okay. One last question. What is Ultra Mega Power Project?
Sir, it differs from the normal power project in terms of capacity of generation. Sorry, sir, I forgot. I could not recall it, sir, as of now.
But you had done electrical and electronics engineering. What's the difference between the two?
Sir, an electrical circuit, it cannot make any decision, sir. If you cannot give any input to that, it simply powers the device, sir. But if we see the electronic device, we can give certain instruction to it, sir. For example, sir, if we take the example of microwave oven, the moment it cooks the food, if we can give the timing to it, it can end the supply to it and it will stop the function, sir. So we can give some message to an electronic device.
Okay, what is the role of CEA? Central Electricity Authority. You heard of it?
Yes, sir.
What is their role?
Sir, it helps in regulating the tariff structure and also promotion of various schemes for the development of electricity, sir, especially for the benefit of consumers. It also overlooks the implementation of various legislations that passed by the government, like Electricity Amendment Bill, Electricity Amendment Act, sir. So, sir, these are some major functions of Central Electricity Authority, sir.
In the electricity pricing, we have the concept of two-part tariff. You have any idea about what is a two-part tariff?
Sorry, sir, I'm not aware of it, sir.
Okay. Now, what are T&D losses?
So they are transmission and distribution losses, sir. We have our power grid, which has both transmission network and distribution network, sir. And with increasing length of the wires, sir, the losses increases. There are losses in both transmission network and distribution network, sir. They are mostly technical losses, sir.
Theft is also part of that?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, what is PLF, planned load factor? What is the function of that?
Sir, it signifies the efficiency of the power plant.
Do you have any idea about the average for India, PLF?
Sir, I could not recall exactly.
See, economic survey, it will give you, is it 60, 70, any rough idea?
Okay. Sir,
now, day ball cricket, that's a very interesting thing. But don't you think it will add to the weight of the ball? Now, normally, what is the weight of a cricket ball? Do you have any idea?
Sir,
when it becomes heavy.
I say it becomes heavy.
So what? No, it should become heavy, obviously. Put a tape. But what will be the effect on the cricket? Will the ball get slow or it will become fast or what? Or it will have no impact on the speed?
Sir, it will have impact, sir.
It will have impact.
Yes, sir.
In what way?
Sir, generally it increases the weight more than a tennis ball. But sir, it helps in bowler with increased weight. He has to put more pressure on his hand to throw the ball, sir. It helps in a bowler developing his capability to deliver the cork ball, sir. He can feel the cork ball a little bit light and he can produce good speed, sir, and also swing in the air.
Don't you think it will spin more after a while? The tape ball?
Yes, sir, it can swing, sir.
Hmm?
Yes, sir.
So now the quality of tape also matters.
Yes, sir.
Apart from the quality of the ball. Okay, now talking of Andhra Pradesh and multiple capitals, what happened to the old Amravati? Is it still there?
Yes, sir, it is still there, sir. It is also part of the new three capitals proposal also as a legislative capital, sir.
But, so many promises were made.
Yes, sir.
Even some foreign government is involved, right?
Yes, sir, Singapore government. Sir, it is Singapore government.
Singapore, they already invested. So, if you again create more capitals, don't you think the importance of this particular Amravati goes down? And profitability, obviously, you know, in terms of development and things like that. So, do you think it's a good policy?
Sir, with respect to three capitals, sir. Yes, sir. The idea behind it is good, sir.
What is the idea? Tell me what is the
sir,
idea.
Sir, it aims to promote decentralization of the state, sir, and also the inclusive development.
There are not better ways of doing that.
Yes, sir.
Decentralization can yes, be sir. Done very many ways, yes, different sir. Ways. Creating yes, capital perhaps is the least desired and the easiest one.
Yes, sir. I do agree with that, sir.
Huh?
Yes, sir. I agree with that, sir. But it is not a feasible idea, sir, in my opinion. Because the distance between the three capitals will be more than 400 kilometers, sir. And in our parliamentary form of government, sir, the interaction between executive and legislature will be very high. So, sir, it is not a feasible idea as of now, sir. And we can promote decentralization and inclusive development through some other methods like promoting urban local bodies and rural local bodies and also smart cities across the state, sir. So, this is what I think about
it, sir. Okay, good. Tell me, what is the role of a Reserve Bank? Some people say Reserve Bank should be privatized. What is the role of a Reserve Bank?
Sir, Reserve
Bank. Should government have any control on that?
Yes, sir. Sir, Reserve Bank, it aims to promote the price stability in our country, sir. And also it deals with various open market operations. It helps government, especially in the times of financial crunch. And also, sir, it aims for the monetary policy transmission for the consumer benefit, sir. So these are some major measures that Reserve Bank of India takes, sir.
No, should it be given more autonomy? Even say appointment of a governor, why not advertise, call for applications and then appoint?
Sir, it should have a certain amount of autonomy, sir. But at the same time, sir, the elected representatives are the ultimate responsibility for the people. So it should act on the basis of the government interests also, sir. So there is a need for certain amount of control on the RBI also, but the autonomy with respect to its functioning, objectively, there should be some autonomy, sir, in my opinion.
Now, of late, one can see some sort of lateral entry in government service.
Yes,
what
sir.
Do you think of it? At the joint secretary level, they are taking people, you know, maybe at other levels also, perhaps it might come through. What is your personal opinion? Do you think it's a good thing?
So personally, I think, sir, it is a very good step. It improves the domain expertise into our administration. If someone is doing good in the corporate sector, sir, it brings that expertise. And also, sir, it boosts the morale of the working bureaucrats or the government servants to act in a more productive manner and in an efficient manner, sir. So the competition will be there. They have to level up their skills to act in a, at the level of the lateral entrance, sir.
No, but the point is private sector is very different from government sector.
Yes, sir.
Your hierarchy and so many
yes, sir.
Other factors are there, you know. While private sector is different, they want results. That's it. More than, you know, hierarchy or this, that.
Yes, sir. Sir, I think...
So, you think they'll be able to fit in and it will not create any problem?
Sir, we are not completely going for the lateral entry, sir. There are only 10 to 20 posts being recruited. Sir, I think the corporate sector view or the outsider view will also be inducted into our decision making, sir, if we have lateral entrance. As of now, sir, if we think from the government perspective, it will be only one-sided. If we can induct some corporate entrance, corporate or the lateral entrance into the administration, sir, the outsider perspective will also be there.
You have opted for foreign service also?
Yes, sir. It is my third option, sir.
Okay. Now, even at the ambassador level, people are appointed. They are, yes, I mean, not necessarily from the service. So, you think it's a good idea?
Yes, sir. Be it anywhere in the administration, sir, a lateral entrance adds value to our working nature. They'll bring expertise, sir. If they are good at something, sir, I think we can utilize their potential there, sir.
Okay, last question. Name one eminent politician, living or dead, from Andhra Pradesh. Now Andhra Pradesh. Yeah. Andhra Pradesh now. prominent Indian politician, at least one name.
Sir, a living person, sir?
Living or dead?
Living, or, sorry, dead. Sir. Living or dead, and the pastor.
One, right? Sir, P.V. Narasimha Rao.
From which district?
He was from which district? Sir, he is a part of earlier Andhra Pradesh, sir, but now the district went into Telangana, sir. I'm not exactly aware of the district, sir.
You don't know the name. Thank you.